Hey, hey, what's up, guys? Thank you for watching another of my videos. What I bring you here today is a Star Wars The Black Series, The Mandalorian, and The Mando. This is the Hasbro one, the action figures from Hasbro, so I'm just gonna give you a quick look how it looks. Just got it, actually. It took me a long time to be able to get one for a good price too, because right now, like, you can imagine all these kind of items are overpriced. This Mando has the Beskar armor, so it's from season 2. I actually want to get one from season 1 because it's very, very good too. We're gonna actually start doing this. I know I got 2 cameras, guys, so forgive me with this, but I'm very excited, as you guys can tell, because this is one of the Disney best things that I can actually talk about. This is my favorite show from Disney, so oh my, I don't even know how to get them out, so let's get them out. Oh, I don't want to break them. Whoa, I didn't see that. He brings a little Batman cape. So I gotta real be careful with this. I don't wanna break the cape or damage any other materials. As you guys can see, the Beskar armor here, shoulders, helmet. And this amazing thing. The most amazing thing is this. Okay, are these supposed to be his fingers? His gloves? The fingers? Yeah, they're a little off. I don't know if it is just me, but the color doesn't really match the skin color. No fingernails. Well, it's very hard and difficult to really give detail to those kind of parts. I've been seeing that as SH figures, but that's crazy overpriced. Alright, so everything else, the cape. Oh, you can actually take the cape off. Can I take the helmet off? Well, I don't know, but can I take the cape off? I wonder, can I take the helmet off? Oh, I don't want to. I feel I'm gonna break him, but well, I should be able to take. Okay, cape came right off. All right. So this part has the Beskar in the back too, and I'm very happy because it actually brings his rifle. That's very good. Where you can put the rifle here or here? I don't really know, or maybe not there, but. Oh, here. Get his rifle there. Rifle there. I'm sorry, guys. I'm just very new. This is my only action figure from the Black Series. And it brings this. This is... Oh, no. That's what was here. The jetpack. So this is the jetpack. Looks good. Details are very good. And I really got to look at the show again. I'm just not color. It could have been a little better, like the Beskar armor. I feel they should have done a little chrome. But it's... Wait. Let me see this. We can actually take it off. Feels like you can actually take off the shoulder pads. It's glued on. That's it. It's only really glued on. So I imagine the helmet, you can take it off. Shins. I like the shins. I just think the hands need a little bit of better color. And like the whole armor itself, it needs to be shiny. But it's a Hasbro one, so. Oh, whoa, whoa. The gun. It flew off. Sorry, guys. So. Let me see. I need to really place it there. Okay, the gun goes here. Gun is very detailed. I like the color. That's the color I thought the Beskar armor was gonna have. Kind of something like that. All right. The gun pouch, it actually opens and closes. All right. Well, I guess rifle. Where can I put the rifle? Why does it bring this? Sorry, guys. I kind of forgot. I looked at the whole show. But it's a little harder. Okay. We can do that. The cape. Cape is just some sort of plastic. Sorry, guys. Okay. Some sort of, you know, regular material that they use. It's rubber, so it's still flexible. I like it like this. You can actually do this with it. You can put the jetpack real quick. Undo this. It does look like the cape is choking him though. But overall, it has a lot of good in it. So, details of the arms are good. Arms mobility is very difficult, so it's not the best mobility in the world. Mobility here is too very difficult. How's the shoulder mobility? Because of the Beskar armor is very limited. See here, way more limited because of the belt right here. Head mobility feels pretty good depending on this cape, but yeah, that's fixable. You can try to make one with real fabric. Legs mobility, you know, it's always, it's very difficult here and there. Feet, it's a little bit of work, but it's good, you know. I like this parts that are actually very flexible because you need them. Turn around. Yeah, I just feel it's gonna lose the paint very quick if you start hitting it with older stuff. But I like it, man. This is the Mando. This is the first Mando I got. Come on. First Mando I got, and it's very good. Like I said, this thing with the belt is gonna be a little tricky. You cannot turn around his whole body, and you have to take the belt off. I wonder how you can do that. So I guess you gotta take it apart to be able to fix those issues. Okay, but overall, I think it's a good purchase. It does look like Mando. It is missing a couple big details, like the paint job. I feel they try to recreate it the best they could, but it should have been more like stainless steel, and this is a silver paint. Needed more of a chrome touch to it, like this one's. But I really gotta rewatch. It's a Beskar. But I remember it was very shiny, like a darker shiny. And this is still good, but I don't know if you guys know what I mean. But the weapons, they hold it for what you expect. Mm-hmm. How will he grab this? Is it like this? Not like this. Sorry guys, I'm just trying to understand a couple things of this. But yeah, so it's a good action figure. And we're gonna put it back. This shows every detail that you can expect from Mando. It's Hasbro one, so it is good. If you want something a little crazier, you can buy the 1/12 inch from Hot Toys, and that's gonna give you a real look and feel to it, because they put actual real fabric on the clothes and blah blah blah. But this one is good as you can get for the price that it is, because it's very affordable and it still shows all the details and brings weapons, and they're very detailed. You could get that as a triggers, but that goes for like 10 times more the price. So it's a big difference in price. What you could do actually, if there's certain things you don't like with this, you can just repaint it yourself and make it custom. But it's good. It's a very good action figure, a lot of details, and it holds to what it's supposed to be. Bring the Mandalorian back to what we wanted in our home. I wish we could get more episodes on it. But it brings the Mando back to life, let's say it like that, like Pedro Pascal. But my thing that I really think it was missing is maybe one head without the helmet, or being able to take the helmet off. That will make things a little more interesting, even though Mandos don't really take their helmet off. But it will help, you know. We'll make a helmet with different details, even though we haven't seen anything different in the show. But overall, it's a great figure. I really like it. Mobility-wise, it's lacking a little bit, but that's just really fixable. All you need is to do it yourself with a couple things. I don't like really opening it unless I have a second figure. And I'm sure I'm not going to mess them up. And I do have a lot of figures that I got to fix, because the mobility is a big issue. Like, the joints are a little bit of difficult time to actually post them and stuff like that. But if you're going to use them for just pictures here and there, that's perfect. You put it back in the box and you leave it there, so you have nothing to worry about. For what I do want them, it's a little more complicated, so I really need better mobility in the toys. But I love it. It's a really good figure for what you pay for. Okay guys, so thank you for watching. I really appreciate comment, like, subscribe, you know the whole deal. Have a good one guys. Peace. And I leave you with some Mando love here.